cousin, one Arthur McBride, as we went walking down by the seaside. Now mark what did follow and what did betide. For it being on Christmas morning, out for recreation we went on a tramp, and we met Sergeant Napper and Corporal Vamp, and a little wee drummer intending to camp. For the day being pleasant and charming, good morning, the sergeant did cry, and the same to you gentlemen we did reply. Well meaning no harm, but just meant to pass by. For the day being pleasant and charming, well it's you my fine fellows if you will enlist. It's 10 guineas of gold I will slip in your fist, and a crown in the bargain for to kick up the dust, and drink the king's health in the morning. For a soldier he leads a very fine life, and he always is blessed with a charming young wife, and he pays all his debts without sorrow or strife, and always lives pleasant and charming. And the soldier he always is decent and clean, in the finest of clothing he's constantly seen, while other poor fellows go dirty and mean, and sup on thin gruel in the morning. Scruples for to send us to France, where we would get shot without warning. You insult me with one other word, I'll cut off your heads in the morning. Oh, Arthur and I, we soon grew our hearts, and we scarce gave them time for to draw their own blades. A trusty shillelagh came over their heads, and bade them take that as fair warning. And them old rusty rapiers, it hung by the side with long as far as we could in the time. Take a mood, devils, cried Arthur McBride. Temper the hedge in the morning, And the little wee drummer, we flattened his paw, and we made a football of his rowdy-dow-dow. Threw it in the tide for to rock and to roll, and we bade it a tea just returning. Oh, we haven't no money, paid them off in cracks, and we paid no respect to the two bloody backs. We lathered them there like a pair of wet sacks, and left them for dead in the morning. Aye, the little wee drummer, we flattened his paw, and we made a football of his rowdy-dow-dow. Threw it in the tide for to rock and to roll, and we bade it a tea just returning then.
I don't know if Rory told you earlier, we had a bit of an interesting time setting up for this gig. John and I did a very late one last night. We finished playing at about 3:30 in the morning, and it's okay because we're coming here to this beautiful venue to play for lovely folk.
Yes.
And I got a call from Rory at about 4:00 going, "Alistair, the desk's blown up. Have you got one?" I was like, "Yeah, okay, I've just bought one. I've just got this desk last week. Brilliant, bring it down." That one blew up as well. Which is why we're going through these wee amps here. But is it okay, the sound? Is there anything that we could... Yeah? Hi, Morven. Anyway, this is... Will you tell them about it? You know it more.
It's a Mexican folk song. It's called La Llorona, which is... La Llorona means... The woman who cries, the crying woman. It doesn't make a hell of a lot of sense, but it's a beautiful song.
Cuando potevi saliste del tiempo un día llorona cuando al pasar yo te vi no
Yeah.
very much.
So, this is the first time we've actually written a set list in a very long time, years definitely. Having done that, we're going to divert from it immediately because John's just broken a string.
It's the first time I've broken a string for ages, and usually, like, if you've seen our band before, you'll be like, can I break a string in this one?
We'd lose John otherwise, that's the thing. Anyway, while John does that, I'll play you a tune. This is... I've not played this in a long time. It's a tune I wrote in Lisbon a few years ago when I got stuck there due to volcanic activity. It's true. There was a volcano in Iceland. We were grounded for a week. It was amazing. Anyway, I found a bar at the top of one of the hills in Lisbon and situated myself there for the entirety of the week. It was lovely, you could see over the whole city. And I wrote a tune about the place called Esplanada de Grasa.
We're going to go back to Ireland. This is a strange song. It's called The Well Below the Valley-O. I'll let you try and decipher your own meaning from it, because it's a very strange song. Maybe we can discuss later.
Gentleman came passing by and he asked for a drink, 'cause he was dry. At the well below the valley, oh, green grows a lily, oh, right among the bushes, oh. My cup is full up to the brim, and if I were to stoop, I might fall in at the well below the valley, oh. Green grows a lily, oh, right among the bushes, oh. If your true love was passing by, you'd fill him a drink if he was dry at the well below the valley, oh. Green grows a lily, oh, right among the bushes, where there's one of them by your Uncle Tom at the well below the myself at the well below the valley, oh. Green grows a lily, oh. Rides among the bushes, oh. There'll be 7 years of ringing the bell at the well below the valley, oh. 7 years of burning in hell at the well below the valley, oh. I'll be 7 years a ringing the bell at the well below the valley. I'll be 7 years a ringing the bell at the well below the valley. But the Lord above will save my soul from ringing the bell at the well below the valley. Right among the bushes, oh, at the well below the valley, oh, green grows a lily, oh, right among the bushes, oh, at the well below the valley, oh, green grows a lily, oh, right among
forward to this next one for two reasons. Firstly, because John is absolutely bricking himself about it. And secondly, because it's written by Dakota Jim, who you saw playing with Louisa earlier. It's a really, really beautiful song that I've played with Jim many times and then started playing with John, except John does it in the wrong key. don't tell Jim. Anyway, it's called Thunderstorm.
Jim, you might want to go out for a cigarette. Try not to do it in Jim's accent. I can't. If I was a thunderstorm, full of anger, full of pain, a thunder. But I can be a thunderstorm, and I know what you've been through. So I guess I'll spend a long, long time thinking about you. If I was a thunderstorm, if I was a thunderstorm.
If I was a baby bird sitting helpless in my tree, oh, I would sing a little song so you'd come and rescue me. But I can't be a baby bird, and I know what you've been through, so I guess I'll spend a long, long time thinking about you.
Dakota Jimmy, you should be applauding for that one. I've got you. The second verse of that song, I always have a little giggle. And I don't think I've told Jim this either. But when I first heard this song, I had it going round and round in my head, and I was just in love with this song. And I was driving and I stopped to go for a pee in the bushes. It was summer and the flowers were out, and I was having a wee pee in the bushes, and a bumblebee came along. And it was just going... And clear as day, I saw Jim's face on this bumblebee. He went, "Hey, John, you want to take some acid?"
Butterfly and
all that stuff.
Aquaplane.
We're going to do you a set of tunes now. The first one is a very well-known Irish slip jig called The Butterfly. In typical fashion, we do a little bit back to front. Second tune is called Le Boite aux Frissons, which is from France, and it means the box of shivers. Thank you.
Right, this is a Romany song. It's a Romany gypsy song. Started learning it out in Macedonia. Do you know what? I'm just gonna stop talking, because usually, like, when we play gigs, got to be all like, "Hi! We're the John Langan Band! I'm really happy! Party, party!" But I don't have to do that here, do I? So I'm just gonna shush and play some music.
Sauron,
A couple of years ago, John went away on his honeymoon to... It was Macedonia, wasn't it?
Macedonia.
And we just lost him for months. So myself and Dave, our other bandmate, we both moved to London in that time to sow our wild oats elsewhere. And the only thing I heard of John throughout that time was from a member of the audience here called Mr. Jez Hellard. Who had been travelling with them for a bit around Macedonia and had various anecdotes that I won't repeat here. But the reason for that careless segue is to mention an album that Jez has just put out. Anyway, shameless plugging aside. Move and I?
Yeah.
Yeah, go on.
Yeah.
At least do one Scottish song. Yeah, move an eye, poor man's son. Rory, are we good for three? Yeah.
So there's an old Scottish song called My Roving Eye. You get it, Roving Eye. Roving, looking at all the lassies. But I kind of rewrote it a little bit. It's the story of how I met an ex-girlfriend of mine in Glasgow. A wee lassie for Dundee.
Are you allowed to sing this one?
Not with my wife's here, no.
You're all complicit.
Nobody gave my wife the YouTube code for the streaming thing, no? For as I gaed adoon the woodlands road, I spied a bonny wee lass. So I walked along and I sang my song, and she stopped dead in her tracks. Wee my roving eye, the fella dee a die, wee my roving eye, dum dee dee, wee my roving eye. She said, Mister, what are you singing? Are you singing? It's me. Oh, did you drop your marbles for the branches of a gum tree? Away my roving eye, a fella dee had aye, away my roving eye, dum dee dee, away my roving eye.
Thank you.
Terribly sorry, I totally forgot the words. It's been a long time, as I said. And I guess I got nervous because I forgot the words and I broke another string, so Ali's going to play another tune.
I always have one sort of trick tune up my sleeve. Two's a tricky one. Okay. This is a tune by Neil Guy, who is a famous 18th century, Ewan? 1780s, yeah. He was around a while ago. He was a fiddler resident in Perthshire, I believe. He wrote a vast quantity of the sort of modern Scottish fiddle repertoire. This is a tune of his called Neil Guy's Lament for the Death of His Second Wife.
That's what's going to happen every time I break a string. I'm going to break some more strings.
You never say stuff like that with Dave's around.
start that show.
This is a song by a great singer called Chris Drever. It's called Poor Man's Song.
Poor man, not pond man.
Oh, by the way, while John's tuning up, firstly, can we say a massive thanks to Rory for having us here tonight? It's such a beautiful room to play at. I think you, us notwithstanding, I think you've got the better view because that's just black, whereas you've got all of this. Apart from us, I'm sorry you have to look at that, but such a beautiful place to be able to play, and we're really grateful for that. And also for Whiskey Moonface for playing such a stupendous set. We've been recording all of the stuff tonight, so if any of it makes the grain, then we'll stick it up online and we'll link it to the event from this page, so keep your eyes out for that.
to believe.
This has been a real pleasure tonight. We never get to play this set, really, apart from maybe 4 in the morning in the Small World tent. Where it goes by another name, but we won't go into that now. Yeah, this is going to be our last tune. Thank you so much for coming down. Feel free to sing along as well, by the way.
Thank you.
friend of mine, true love should die. I would never find another to boil mountain time from around the blooming heather. Oh, I say, will you go, lassie?
Yeah, good health, a lot of you. Cheers.
Not that we would have just ploughed on and done it anyway. I mean, not our style.
Is Rory's Ma out there?
Yes.
I've never met you before, but this song's for you.
The brave and the bold, they came for sport.
golden kill. They're but jovial conversations at the cross of Spansel and Hill. Enchanted by the novelty, delighted by the scene, wherein Beelzebub had so often I had been, I thought I had a murmur, I'm sure I hear it still. It's that little stream of water that flows down Spansel Hill. And a tear came to my eyes in hope to see that dear old land someday before. the joyous kings of angels, and the choicest blessing spill on the dear old spot of nature that's across the Spansel Hill.
Thanks very much, folks. What an absolute pleasure. Thanks for coming. See you.